Hello and welcome. Today, or maybe tonight almost, I will cast for you BSL 7, the Chobo League, a round of 8. Just two matches between players Art of Turtle and Coffee Session. And second one will be Laser Snipe versus Jedi One, and both matchups are mirror matches. Art of Turtle and Coffee Session are Zergs, and Laser Snipe and Jedi One are both Protosses. Today I am alone here, so I'll be casting lonely. No one wants to help me with that. But anyway, I hope in some good games, so it will be much easier for me. Just sometime I can be a little bit worse in English than I want to be. So excuse this little disadvantage on my side. And well, there is nothing to wait for. You can go directly into the first game between Art of Turtle and Coffee Session. ZVZ. Map is Bloody Ridge. Well, in ZVZ, that map name is well fit. So, both players made their way into the round of 8. ZVZ is hard matchup because it's not so much about skill, but it's a lot about luck. You know, if you are a good player and your enemy surprises you with some fast links or so, it's always hard to win, almost impossible. I will try to change their colors to be better visible the name of Coffee Session. So, Blue Zerg on bottom left corner. This is Coffee Session. By the way, he is from Poland, Central Europe. He's asking what's favorite movie of Art of Turtle, which is Red Zerg on top right corner. Art of Turtle don't know what is his favorite movie. Maybe we will find out soon. And this map is just for two players. These maps are even harder for ZVZ because there is so many possibilities what you can do. Art of Turtle need to think about favorite movie. You know, but Coffee Session risks his fast expansion, and against him, Art of Turtle, his spawning pool is after half progress. Hello, Koblížek, hello everyone. Welcome on this stream. This is all or nothing duel, because if you win, you can go into the quarterfinals. Oh, no, sorry, semifinals. Best of four. And if you lose, you are just out of the tournament. By the way, these games in quarterfinals are played as best of five. So at least three game. First links from Art of Turtle heading into the Coffee Session base. This spawning pool just finished. Well, if he defend these links, he's in very good spot because he will have one hatchery, one more hatchery than his opponent. Links are in six. 8, but these dwellings are too far away. These are chairs should survive. If yes, coffee station is in so good spot. This position will be, these links need to join into the battle. And this was so good for coffee station. 5 of his links survived, another 2, and now advantage of one more hatchery will be so big in this matchup. What's plan for Art of Tartle now? He can try to make Spiral, but he needs some defense right now, because there will be much more links from Art of, from Coffee Session. You know, he is not going even for Lair, just massing his links. And maybe he should stop mining gas, I think. More and more red links dying. Yeah, this creep colony should need to be changed into the sunken colony. But, you know, that, oh my, no, these 3 drones are not mining at all. This is big mistake from Art of Tartle. And, well, no drone killed yet. It's much better than he could expect, but more and more links on way. And speed is finished, and now it's going to be very hard for Art of Tartle. Because he has no almost minerals. And what about drones? No drones still killed. It's still okay, but no, this is going to be very bad for Art of Tartle. You know, more and more links. First drone die, and now nothing prevents, nothing will help this drone in survive. And this is going to be GG very soon. Oh, this was disaster. GG, Art of Tartle knows he lost this game. So after very, very fast game, Coffee Session get his lead 1-0. I will just update score and we can go into the second game. You know, ZVZ are very often very fast games. Oh, in some longer ones. But ZVZ is really hard. Map is neo-silified. Map for just 3 players. Yeah. Well, first game was really fast and Coffee Session uses his advantage of one hatchery so well. Now Art of Tartle need to do something about Siri. You don't want to be in a shortage of 2 games, because then you need to win 3 in a row. So it will be plan for both players right now. 3 player maps. Well, Art of Tartle will find his opponent a little bit sooner. No spawning pool yet on either side. And well, maybe another fast expansion for Coffee Session, looks like. Yeah, it will be fast expand again. And well, will be this time again successfully that strategy. ZVZ is very low eco matchup, you know. Every single drone is so expensive for you. Especially if you need more and more zeroings. Spawning pool in progress, like in the previous game. So far, Almost same game as last one, just different map. And now the Art of Battle, see the expansion. No, yeah, he found it, so now he knows what he's against. Compared to percentage of completing this hatchery, he knows that there will be later spawning pool than he has, but other thing is he'll have later his hatchery. 6 links in progress. Will be finished very soon. And same amount on the other side. And even one more. So
yes.
8 links.
Come, follow me. Follow.
Thank you for following me. I appreciate it. Okay, 6 links are on way. I think it's still almost same game as last one. I am happy they don't play the same map, because I would then think that I loaded wrong replay. Again, more links on coffee session. Still no lair on either side. Same amount of drones, 9 and 9. What? Art of Tartle has a bit higher mineral amount. This sunken cone is so important. He needs to block these links out of his main base, because when they reach the main base, they can kill some drones. And this matchup is all about mining and drones. Now Coffee Station has 2 more drones, a little bit risky, but if game will be longer, it's good for him. Now attacking both links, and now Coffee Station can sneak into the Art of Tartarus base, and now, well, he needs to defend all his drones. It can be so dangerous for him. Every single drone count. No attack here, just link against link. It's like some Chinese name, Link Link. 4 links, there should not be done any more damage. And, well, Coffee Session should be cautious about this, because amount of links on Art of Tartar side is going to be out of control completely. There is no lair, and one sunken will not be enough. And Art of Tartle sniffed that. Even if he lost some drones right now, he'll have so much more. These links are going for his victories. You know, one sunken colony, this will not get in time. And how many links here? 6? Well, fresh ones, but so many links. Okay, this is going to be end for Coffee Session. I don't believe he will be able to defend, even if this link is going for some kill. But after killing this hatchery, and even here, link have 2 kills, Coffee Session knows he lost, and series tied up into 1-1. But again, a very fast game. I hope this stream will be a little bit longer than half hour. So 1-1. Now we need to go into the third game. Map is multiverse. Okay, it's for first time we will see four player map, but still there is possibility to find your opponent really soon. This map is very Python like, you know, map Python is almost the same. I can level entire map to show you, because these expansions are behind some walls which can be mined through by drones or probes or so. But rest of map is simply like Python, except this wall which can be destroyed. Warfare is going for scout with their overlords into the nearest position, but they are on the same side of map, just longer distance. And again, these positions are good for some links. Will Coffee Session go again for fast expansion? Yeah, he will. He don't feel any fear. You know, this is really fearless strategy, especially in ZvZ, and especially in games when you can expect, according to last two games, mass links. And again, a Heart of Turtle is going for a faster spawning pool. Well, both players trying just one strategy all the time. But Coffee Session have really good timings. You know, even if Heart of Turtle is going for a little bit faster spawning pool, his links will not reach Coffee Session's base in time to kill something really important. Extractor trick to make one more drone. It's good one in ZvZ with this strategy. Just need to send his drones a little bit better to not mine over the spawning pool. What's the Art of Turtle base? First six links in progress. Well, same on the other side. No, another two. Ah, Coffee Session is complaining about some luck. I hope this game will not be affected by this. I mean, luck is always really bad. Oh, they have been waiting for about half minute and now it seems okay. No more complaints. You know, especially in mirror matches, if you can't micro properly, it's always really, really hard. Oh, third hatchery. Very risky. This overlord will find it very soon. And what's the armies? 8 links against 10 links. But another 2 here. Creep colony. Hard to see if he will make sunk in time. First engage. Heart of Turtle need to go back. And here. Speedlings already. Not so Coffee Session. Well, now Heart of Turtle should attack, I think. Because this Aurora scouts what's happening here. And Coffee Session for some time can't make so many links like Heart of Turtle, you know. He spent 300 minerals on his archery. But Heart of Turtle is going for, I think, Spire, yeah. Well, I don't think it's a good idea. Now he should go for mass links. Spire is a building which needs so much time to get up. And still don't know why Coffee Session didn't make it. Oh, he didn't even start it to mine gas. Just many of slow links. Stealings can be dangerous, but, well, so many links, even with slow movement. Well, now it's all about this. There are drones dying and water. If Coffee Station wins his battle, you know, speedlink is much better than slow one. There is sunken colony, it's really so-so. And, oh, almost defended so well, but now, well, okay, it's so okay for Arthur Cardinal. I think he just need to make another sunken here. But, you know, there are some drones have been killed. So much mining time. Just 5 drones. And now it's everything in Art of Tartar's hands. This is the time when he needs to mass his links, and even one Mutalis can be so dangerous. Well, he doesn't need to wait, he needs to attack. Right now. And make more links or just few Mutas. Why is going back? This is bad decision. This is so bad for him. No, you have every possible advantage in game. So why not attack? You have speedlinks, you have Mutas, and you are giving your opponent time. Why? You have more drones? Even in that really important aspect of game, you have advantage, so go for it. Well, do not kill these overlords. You need to kill drones. If you kill rest of these drones, you are winner of game. Why you are giving your opponent so much time? Well, this is really mind game, which is Art of Tartar losing right now. No. Why are you waiting so long? Now Lynx should again win. Yeah, this is good for Art of Tartar. Yeah. Even if he was waiting for so long, still his advantage was so big that he easily won this game. And Art of Tartar is now in lead 2-1 and is just one game from moving into round of 4 semifinals. So there will be 4th game. Map Ground Zero. It's the largest map we have seen so far, compared to possible starting locations. And again, 4-player map. So I can really hope in some longer game, because all these games were so fast. And there it is, Art of Tartar, Red Zerg in top right corner, winner of last game, or previous if you wish, and Coffee Session, his opponent, Blue Zerg in bottom left corner, so it's cross position. Again, there is highest possibility to make some macro game, longer one. So, we will win this game if Art of Tartar is in round of 4, if Coffee Session will see 5th game. Drones, everything just the same right now. And will Coffee Session go again for his second hatchery? maybe there is extra core trick. Same on the other side. Or you let this extractor finish. Well, okay. It can mean you'll go for really fast links. To mine just 100 gas and make your speed links as fast as possible. And there it is, Coffee Session is again going for Hatchery first. Before spawning pool. Another extractor trick to make 10/9. And if Art of Tartle will make his speedlinks in time, I don't think there is chance for Coffee Session to defend this. The speedlinks are so good against slow links. Even if it is only about movement, still it's much better. Another extractor trick, it's third one in Coffee Session build order. Finally building Overlord. In favor of Coffee Session is that Art of Tartle will not find him too soon. But he played 3 times in a row fast expansion. And I think Art of Tartle counts with that. Fast lair. It's so fast as possible. No lair on Coffee Session base. No, he didn't even start mining gas. And first link. 4 links going into some just now defense. I think Coffee Session will stop his links on top of ramp 2. But Art of Tartle is in some 3/4 of lair. And what's defense of Coffee Session? No, he's just going for another mass links, but slow ones. But you know, he forgot to send second overlord for scouting, and Art of Tartle will find his opponent much faster. He will know much earlier what he is against. More and more links, just links, but there is Spire in progress. And now things are going to be really bad for Coffee Session if he needs to make some anti-air defense. And if you go for 3 archeries, now you need to go to attack. Just now, you can't wait, you need to overmass your opponent. Especially if you don't know where he is, just need to go. You don't have time for this. And on the other side, Art of Tartle need to defend this till his mutas pop up. Coffee Session is trying to find his opponent. On cross position, it's good. Well, there will be no anti-air defense yet, because there is no evolution chamber, so no possibility to build some spore colonies, no gas, and now it's everything about defense. But 6 mutas are going to be made, and this will be disaster for Coffee Session. Micro in Zeroing against Zeroing, it's very hard or almost impossible. Still, Art of Tartle getting his time. He needs to. Well, he maybe will finish this Sunk Colony too, but now so many links at Art of Tartle base. And how many drones he will die, he will kill. He is targeting Spire, but I don't think it's a good idea. He needs to kill drones, I think. And this this is disaster for Coffee Session. Zerg Spire will survive this attack. He will now lose his overworld and no defense against these mutas. Even Sunken Colony is almost in full health. And now, no, this is so bad for coffee session. Well, still getting some time, but his units will just die in some miserable death. And what he can do, he can build Spore Colony, but count the drones. 10 to 7, he need to build another Spore Colony, so it's 10 to 6. And you don't have any single point of gas. So these mutas will not find his moving enemy for so long time. And I don't think this spawning pool is protected by this Spore Colony. So, no, he's heading for find some expansion. There is no one. Well, coffee session is literally cornered from his opponent. And you know, now if Art of Tartar makes some links and he's doing that, what's defense against them here? Well, nothing. Simply nothing. So, I would say that coffee session is living last few seconds in BSL because there is simply no possible defense against all these units which are going towards his base. Well played by both uses different strategies, but Art of Tartar just uses it a little bit better. And you know, so many links against one link in move. And just one Sunken Colony. Even if you finish these Zerlings, it's too late. Spawning pool is going to die. This is GG. I don't think there is simply any possible thing which can defend coffee session against losing in this game. There is that spawning pool, that Sunken Colony, and drones are dying, last seconds are counting, and this is GG. Art of Tartar win this duel 3-1, and wish best of luck for in the tour. It's good, Manred, I appreciate this. It's always to see, even if you kill your opponents, you just know it's just a game and you respect your opponent. Be good manner, never forget about this. So 3-1, Art of Tartar 3 against Coffee Session 1. Art of Tartar is moving into the semifinals. Round of 4, you know, he's now in best 4 players position in BSL 7 Chobo League. Congratulations! But now we have second duel here, and it will be Laser Snipe against Jedi One. And for change, it will be PvP. Laser Snipe was the player I have been casting last week, if I remember well. I mean, just change the names and score. Give me a few seconds. So, PvP, from my point of view, by the way, If I play some games, I'm almost always play Protoss. PvP is my less favorite matchup. I don't really know how to win this game in PvP. It is so hard, every single mistake is so well punished by your enemy. I never learned, even if I'm playing the StarCraft World War from very beginning, still PvP is like cursed for me. I'll change the course. So there it is, Jedi 1. I really don't know his stats, by the way, because I never found his nick on the BSL 7 main page. Only thing I know about him, he should be from Russia. So, Jedi 1, Blue Protoss on 12th position. 12 hours, of course. And there, Laser Snipe, Green Protoss, Canadian. This is so worldwide tournament. It's so good to see so many nations. But only one of these can move and follow Art of Turtle to round of 4. Oh, Jedi 1 is going for some proxy gateways. It will be at least 2 gateways, I think. And this map is so good for it, because it's really small map and this position is not so often scouted. Well, Laser Snipe need to have some luck now. No, he will miss it. He'll miss it absolutely. You'll find out when this probe will reach Jedi 1's base, but it will be too late. Now it's all about good defense. No, he's going for Assimilator. This is so bad for Laser Snipe. Well, I know it from his position right now. As I said, PvP is my worst matchup. And now I feel so sorry about this. Oh, Zealot in progress, and there is... He didn't even doing his first Zealot. This pylon will block at least one probe. Oh, this is well played from Jedi 1. It's for sure, but I just know how Laser Snipe is feeling right now. First Zealot here, and no, he's making his first Zealot. But it won't be enough, at least some shield battery or so. Dragon is worst possibility right now. He needs so many units. At least maybe try to kill some probes with the scouting probe. Oh, this is shield battery. But oh, it's a Jedi 1 battery. Oh, this is going to be so hard to defend, almost impossible, but no probe guide. First probe guide, but no so big damage done yet. Now Laser Slam is in panic mode. Second probe, this is so hard, you know, he's even filling his shields in your main base. First Zealot died finally, but probes are dying still. Laser Snipe is ahead with one probe. It's now 12, no, probes starting to die, it's bad for him. Still trying his best to... Oh! Probes are now in favor of Jedi 1, and this is going to be so bad. Well, he's not making units all the time, but no, this is end, because there is just 6 probes left and Dragon died. This is end of all hope, if you know Nightwish. Well, GG. Shield battery of Laser Snipe here. Well, really know how laser snipe should feel like right now. Whew. Yeah, this is how PvP is ending for me so often. But nothing lost yet. Laser Snipe still have his chances to go to round of 4. Against Jedi 1, by the way, I must say Jedi 1 did it really well. Built his pylon in Laser Snipe's base. Uses shield battery here. It was well done. So now again 3-player map. This map is very good for some cheeses or so, because you will really soon find your opponent. This is very good for some in PvP. It's very good for river drops, zealot drops or so. And not so much for storms. So I think best option here is river. This map has a lot of cliffs, so river drops are good option. Maybe if you wish to use storms again, storms drops, you know, drop your high tempar behind the mineral line and kill it in advance, but it's a little bit harder. And now there is second duel, second match. This is laser snipe, green Protoss on the left side of map, and on the right side of map there is Jedi 1, winner of last game. Hope I will see at least one longer game, because ZVZ all were so fast. I think all of them were under 6 minutes, maybe 7. And the last game in this PvP was about maybe 5 minutes. So now I hope it will be longer one. Or this will be shortest streaming ever. Both players are doing exactly the same right now. No, of course, if you don't cheese, there is no many options what you can change. Laser Snipe is going for a little bit faster scout, but going to wrong direction. And now faster assimilator for Laser Snipe, but I don't think... Oh, double gate? Yeah, double gate, so things are changing very fast again. Double gate against some dragon. Dragon rush. And luckily Jedi 1 will find his opponent sooner. What's going here? Pylon? Maybe later we'll try to hide some tech here. Hard to say. But again, no gas here. But this map is still a little bit longer. Larger, sorry. And I think that Cybercore is good idea to start with in PvP on this map. Of course, if your opponent don't try some proxy gateways. If he is going for double gate from main base, it's still good to start with Speed Dragon. Nothing to blame right now. And if you survive, you are little bit ahead, because you have many options what you can do. You can go for Dark Templars, you can go for just speed loads, you can go for river drops or so. Freezels going into the laser slime's base, again shoot battery. I found Last week, that laser snipe really likes that building, and I like it too. It's a very underestimated building, but so good. It can really change whole matchup. Freezolds against Zeod Dragon, it can be not so bad from laser snipe, but he need to fill his shields on Zeod. He did it right now. Now we need to protect this probe. Move this dragon. Yeah, that is so hard because you need to micro with dragons, you need to micro with probes. First probe died, but on the Jedi one side, so it's 1-1 right now. Second, now it's 3 probes. It's a little bit higher than the Jedi expected, but there is finishing range for laser snipe. And I would say, right when he finishes it, he should try at least to lock Jedi one in his base. Because in PvP, when you are locked in base, it's so hard for you to get out, and your opponent can make some free expansion or so. Yeah, it's good timing, and if you build, if you make hold position these dragons right here, 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 there is no option how Jedi one can easily get out of his base. This probe can be dangerous because it can build some sneaky expansion. You can go up ramp, but you can lock enemy in base. It's so good. And this is not good positioning. You need, yeah, you are now allowing. Oh, good for the laser snipe. You need to no, move back here. You need to lock him up. And if you do it, your opponent just needs to wait till reverse. This is too far away. This dragon should be around here. This around here, and it will be so good. This probe is going not going for some sneaky expansion, but for scouting. Free gateways against free gateways and a robotics facility on both sides, but Jedi one scouted full base of laser snipe. This is bad. And this positioning, really, it needs to be around here. This Jedi one's probe built pylon, and just now laser snipe allowed the Jedi one get out of his base, and this is disaster for him. I think he can just hope that Jedi one will not do the lock in base better than him. This dragon is almost dead. To move up ramp immediately. No, don't spend time here. And now it's good for laser snipe. Jedi one is not going to lock him up. But you know, if you get in this position and lock your enemy in base, it's so hard to break this. Even with reavers, because they are not so clever unit. What's here? Free gateways, robo support bay. Already finished on laser snipe base, still he's in good spot. Yes, and this is what I was talking about. You know, how can laser snipe go out of his base with just dragons? He can't, because if he try, at least 4 to 5 dragons will die for free. He can't attack move because they will stuck on ramp. This is so hard, and even with river, it's really hard. You need to micro him properly. Well, what should laser snipe do to his enemy? His enemy doing to him. It's probably die, but just scouting what's happening here. River need immediately attack. He need to move him here. Now need to risk something. No, don't wait for shuttle. Attack with rivers. Move these dragons here and attack with river. Convince the enemy move out of here. You need expansion soon. And your opponent is Jedi one is going for a river too. And no, this waiting can cost game to laser snipe. He was ahead, but you know, we have more dragons here. If River would attack sooner. No, okay, don't move. Shuttle. And now you see what I was talking about. So many. No. This is just one scarab, and he loses so much. And even you see, even if Jedi one have here so less dragoons, still so hard to go out of the base. And now you can't attack to your enemy again. PvP is so hard in that, because for sure the Jedi one will have a river here, so not attackable at all. Even if laser snipe more dragoons. No, don't attack. Don't. This will be disaster. You can just hope you will kill the river, but it would be so optimistic. Yeah, this is good. Nexus behind that. But Jedi one have good map control. Well, few small mistakes. Where is the river? There. Oh, this is going to be a river and two Zealots drops. Well, still, the Jedi one don't do some great damage. Still, laser snipe has big chance to win. But still don't know what's happening. You will find right now how many probes you will kill. You see 31 probes. 32. Oh, five probes at all. Oh, 6, 7, 8, 9. Don't kill 10 probes. Oh, this is so many probes. And laser snipe was ahead in probe count, but now everything changed and he is behind. This position is absolutely inattackable, unpenetrable with anything till you have much more units than your enemy. Well, oh, this shuttle is going back again. 27 probes. No, this will be so good. 6 probes at one scarab. Phew. I sound like a little bit sad, but you know, I know that situation from my point of view, that PvP, I'm dying on the same things over and over again. And there is speed shuttle already done, and no option how to attack the Jedi one position. It's in so. No, don't unload. Don't unload here, you will lose your river so fast. Still, so far so good, but you need to move them behind your enemy, behind your line. First river died, and this is so bad for laser snipe right now. You know, both rivers from Jedi one survived. You have shuttle, you have more units, you have higher army supply, almost doubled in probe supply. And if he load these rivers into... Oh, I missed river here. Don't know how many kills he have. Maybe I will find out soon. 17 kills! And it was the first river in game which decimated the... Oh, another probes are dying here. This is... Maybe if he... No, there's so much more in Jedi's run army. And even these scarabs are finding their target. You know, Jedi 1 plays really well. He's using Protoss so good. I don't blame Laser Snipe, he is losing this game. because there is not so many mistakes Jedi one done. Well, now we will lose. I think I thought the Jedi one will target the shuttle because it's almost dead. Yeah, and this is there is no option how laser sniper will lose. Just one thing, as Jedi one is good microing, his macro is little bit behind, and you can see he has over 1,000 arrows. Of course, now it's not important, but yeah, these two gates are good thing. But yeah, his Jedi one is playing really good. So many kills with reavers. You see, 12 kills. This one will have some too. Whew. So 2-0. Jedi one is just one step from his dream of round of 4. Well, will he do this last step? We always hear that the step is the hardest possible. Will he do it right now, or will Laser Snipe get his chances back? And there it is, Laser Snipe. I didn't saw what is the map, but I think it's Gladiator. Yeah, it is Gladiator. And biggest danger on this map in PvP is exactly like in the last time what I in last game. You know, I will again enable a full map. If you lock down your enemy in base with dragoons, it's there is even harder to go out because you are down the ramp and units up ramp are so hard to break. Only thing you need to do if you lock up your enemy in base, for example on this position, you just need to make sure he is not able to drop with units. So dragon here, just make full air parties from his base visible and full control of these places, and then you are just one. You can't be defeated, because what's option for your enemy if you lock him here on this map? He just need to brute force a move from his base. He will lose so many units till he will just get up ramp. He can't drop you because you have dragoons all over his base. This map is so hard to break. By the way, I have been defeated by that so many times, and I never did it properly to defeat someone, and I mean someone better, of course. From time to time I win PvP too, but really, from my point of view, it's a really hard matchup. Laser Snipe scouting as well as his opponent Jedi one. Laser Snipe will now find Jedi one first. He knows everything about his base. Maybe he can try lock his probe in mineral line, but not going for that, at least right now. First zealot out, one dragon will follow. What's here? Same thing, just without zealot. No, zealot is here, sorry. And still, Laser Snipe is in dark for his opponent, because Jedi one scouted all the possible positions, but Byl Koreglan. But you can see all timings are the same. Both players playing same strategy. Maybe now Jedi One is going for 200 mirrors for his reverse. I think it will be good because his micro with them is so nice. So what will be here? 200, 200. I bet it will be. It will be robotics facility, but 200 mirrors here too. Maybe robot too. Robo against robo. Nothing yet. Okay. Yeah, it started right now. Little bit, few seconds behind. And what I like about the Jedi One is his map control. He's using his scouting probes also really good. He can be easily surprised, but now if Laser Snipe has some luck, he can sneak into the Jedi One's white. No, 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 this will be catched and killed. Poor probe. Again, both pairs are going same strategy. Two gateways, it will be third one. Just on Jedi One, only two gates. But observatory. What will be here? Observatory too. Still, both pairs are not so different from each other. Shuttle. I didn't saw any robotic support bay. So why shuttle? Maybe Zealot drop or Dragon drop behind minerals. You know, this place in the Ark, it's so close to a mineral line. So dropping any units here is really, really safe. And as defender, you can't have units in base because, as I told before, you can't allow your enemy lock you in base because you are down the cliff. So both pairs are waiting for now. River. Well, I missed. Oh, sorry, I missed completely robotic support bay. I had it behind the overlay of Blizzard itself, so I missed it completely. So there it is, and shuttle speed starting. So again, river play. But there is no robot support bay in Laser Snipe's base. Dragon missed the probe because of high ground. This map is really good for some defending on these high grounds because especially for Terran and Zerg with siege tanks and lurkers. But oh, this river again get some kills. This was so good. This car was so good. I think at least 2 or 3 kills this river get. And now Laser Slug need to go back. And well, no, this car will hurt so much. Well, nicely done. He killed at least this river. But now it will be so hard to defend against army because Laser Snipe have just 3 very damaged dragons against 6 of them. Another 2 waiting here. Oh, one dragon died already. This is hard, this is so hard because your opponent had much more. 2 against 5. And this is... oh. This expansion needs to be cancelled, and that is the spot where it's going to be really hard to win anything. I think maybe some cannons from Jedi One cancelled the Nexus and No, there is no forge, so no cannons yet. Or I missed it already. No, 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 I didn't miss. So there will be no cannons, so maybe shot battery here. And robot support bay is so late. And as I told you... Oh no, no, wrong! No, poor dragon. Rally point. Forge here, so maybe rally some cannons here, because no battery. And Jedi One has all advantages what you can dream of. You know, Nexus in progress, satellite high ground, your enemy has no way how to get out of his base, just need to map control. Now need few dragons around around Laser Snipe's base, and then there is no way how we can win. So sad. This is what this map is about. And there's the cannons, plus one in progress, you know, Citadel Alpha Dune, so speed lots, maybe some kind of storms. Nexus almost finished, and what's your opponent have? You know, it's easy, he have just one chance to make some brutal damage with this shuttle, but no, he will met the enemy shuttle too, and this is two rivers against one. Even with river you can't attack this high ground, because river is really dumb, and if you target these dragons, even with some observer here, he will try to go up the ramp, and that is what Jedi One needs. Map control. Dragons around the laser snipe base, and this is just waiting for that. There is no way how laser snipe can get out of his base. This is almost impenetrable position for Jedi One. Four cannons, if you move here, so many dragons will die. And don't lose the shuttle, maybe the last thing you can think how win. Well, at least something. No, Jedi One killed luckily that river. So I don't think there is any possible way how Laser Snipe can win this game. Maybe some, I don't know, miracle or some hunt of God, or I don't know, I don't really know. So we can just pray for some greatest mistake in, and this is what I was talking about, you see. River is so dumb, even if he has range, he's moving up ramp. Oh, no, don't lose. So, 7 lives. So risky. If Jedi One makes some greatest mistakes in StarCraft history, there is possibility for a laser snipe to win, but you see how hard is micro with River. Shuttle died. Maybe some small pass. No, the reverse in. No. 4 probes survived. Just 3 on gas and 1 on mineral line. Shuttle with 1 reverse survived. This is the end. Well, last try. But this is, Protoss units are so fat and so dumb, it's almost impossible to break the ramp. And look at the difference in armies, in 40 more probes than your opponent. Well, this is These are last few seconds of life of Laser Snipe in BSL7. Today will be a really short day in casting BSL7 round of 8. I really didn't expect it so fast games, especially this PvP, but well, Jedi 1 made everything well, everything so good, and now there is so much more in Jedi 1's side. You know, 5 gateways, not even this river can change anything. You know, maybe if Jedi 1 will now be away from keyboard for 1 hour, but nothing that happened. That means that Laser Snipe is going to an end in this tournament. And this opponent, Jedi 1, moving forward. Well, we have seen today short games, but definitely not bad ones. Well, I have been kicked out of the battle.net for some reason. I am going to read some chat, what you write down. Yeah, Koblížek, I completely agree, PvP is not so good. You used some words I don't like, so Laser Snipe, totally agree, you need to do something after losing so many probes. I think you are talking about second game. Yeah, Laser Snipe, I again agree with you. You made some advanced mistakes, I would say. Like, you didn't lock up your enemy in base in second game. If you do it properly, I don't think he would win this game. The third game, again, if you get into the position you get, it's almost impossible to break, so totally understand, but and I don't think it was some key mistake, it was just a situation. From time to time you get into the situation, and especially on a Gladiator map, there is no way how you can break it. I never seen anyone in PvP on this map, when they get locked in base, they can win. Never, really never. So I completely don't blame you for third game. Yeah, of course, but even if you don't kill the river, if you save all your dragoons, yeah, but if you don't kill the river and you save your dragoons, he will take the river and lock you up anyway, because river against just dragoons, it's really hard to do something with that. So it was lose-lose situation. He just got the rivers much faster than you, and this is maybe, I don't like the word mistake in that case, but if so, it was the mistake which cost you the game. And yeah, absolutely. He got the exact good build against your build. You were in such good spot in second game. That was the game you should win, I think. You just needed to do what Jedi did to you. That was only difference. And if you do that, you are losing so many probes and units and river. You can even lose river, by the way, you lost it in your second game. Then everything changes, card is flipping and you can win. The probes you lost in the second game, they're being killed after the wrong lockdown in base. Really, PvP is very often about these lockdowns in base. Yeah, I can't wait. I will try if you will join the BSL next time. And I hope so. I will try to cast your group. And I can't wait for your progress. Make some hard training and next time you will own this Chobolik. By the way, you are in top 8, round of 8, so I don't think it's bad at all. How many players was here? I will look how many players played Chobolik. If I remember well, it was 6 groups or more. 8 groups. So 8 by 4. Well, it's 32 if I count well. 32 players. And you are in top of 8. I don't think it's bad at all. Still 22 players behind you. So, with that, I must say, today was a really short stream. And it's going to end because there is no more games to cast. I really thank you for your patient with my English. I thank you for watching. Wish you all the best of luck. And maybe sometime later, maybe next week, I don't know if I will be casting round of 4, don't really know. But if so, we will meet again next week. And this Sunday, starting Brood War Clan League, I will be casting it too. So if you wish, you can. Yeah, I think Master Ray will cast some these games. I don't know if Monday or Tuesday, don't really know. I can check it for you. If you give me some time. Okay, okay. So Laser Snipe telling us he will cast with him on Monday or Wednesday. So I will be here as a watcher. I can wait for these games. And for now, it's everything. Really, thank you. Be prepared so for some another games, another castings. Best of luck for all of you. Good night.